I think it's hard to break through because obviously it's incredibly competitive out there. Having said that, when I sit in casting sessions, 90% of the people we see we probably don't want and aren't right. So I feel that if you are one of the lucky few who has that natural talent, you will break through if you are passionate enough about it. The most important thing an actor needs to do in all disciplines is listen, take notes, and follow instructions, but keep the character their own. It's not essential, but it definitely helps if you come to an audition and you've learnt the lines. Certainly if you get a call back and you haven't learnt the lines, you're sort of showing me you're not really interested. So if you're interested in the part, you should have learnt your lines. Listening to notes, taking notes, being able to read something possibly in a completely different way. So come in, give us one performance, and then when we talk to you about it, then possibly give us a completely different performance. Whether it's right or not doesn't actually matter, but it's sometimes it might be showing a range and that it we might think, well, that's not quite right for that actor, that character. But by doing that, you've just shown me that you could be right for another character. And so it's a kind of win-win situation that you're giving yourself more job opportunities. Any experience is good experience in that if you want to act, you need to prove that you really want to act and therefore have been acting. Someone who's not doing any acting obviously isn't that passionate about acting. For me, I would always recommend young actors to start in the theatre. I think we've got a brilliant heritage of theatre in this country, and you will be surrounded by creative, brilliant people, and you will learn from them. But in a sense, I do think there is, acting is as much about natural talent as about what you can learn or what someone can teach you. And in some ways, you've either got that or you haven't. Theatre acting and film and television acting are different things. Theatre acting is much more expressive and about using your eyes and your body and moving around. Film and television acting is about being still. And if somebody comes in and they're jiggling around or fiddling with their top or fiddling with their hair when I'm trying to watch their eyes to see what they're giving me as a performer, that's really distracting. One of the main things you've got to have as a film and television actor, as well as natural talent, is an ability to remember continuity, to remember to pick your cup of tea up on the third line if that's what you did the first time. And so there are basic continuity skills, which I think really you learn by practice and by concentrating. I'm not aware of a course you can go on to learn that, but for me that's about discipline. And I think that's the thing about being an actor. You have to be incredibly disciplined on lots of different levels. I think the role of the agent is very important in that it's a very competitive business. And as much as anything, how do we find our actors? We find our actors because our casting directors send out a brief for a start to agents. So you kind of need to be in the communication chain in order to know that we're auditioning in the first place. I don't think there is a magic way to get an agent. I think also agents, if they're worth having, are probably at your university or RADA shows or general theatre shows spotting you anyway. But certainly to be looking for those first auditions, I think theatre schools with agencies attached are probably a good place to start. I'm not going to give somebody a job because they went to RADA or they didn't go to RADA or any of the other theatre schools. I think it provides you with discipline. And as I say, that's probably the thing that I keep coming back to, is one of the most important things as an actor. And a great learning curve and a great opportunity to make mistakes and get over those mistakes and come out still smiling the other end rather than make mistakes in your professional career. So I think it's brilliant to go to an acting school. I wish I had, but But having said that, you know, there are lots of great actors out there who didn't, and who are just very naturalistic and have something and are able to perform. I think, I suspect the people who have been to the theatre schools have a better, feel more confident in themselves. And actually that is an advantage. But I mean, obviously it all costs money. There are more and more opportunities for actors and anyone involved in film and television globally. The introduction of Netflix and Amazon into the European market and the global market also marks a different level in the playing field. So Free Rain, which we've just made, is the first European Netflix original live action programme for kids. So we're really excited that we've made that. And what's amazing about it is it's going to go out worldwide on the same day, sometime in the summer. And we hope it will appeal to every single country in the same way. The young actors, and it is mainly young actors who we cast, have got an amazing opportunity there because they've immediately been catapulted onto a global platform. What's great, though, is I think they realised that, and they were a lovely group of people, and they had great fun, and we had two young actors over from America. Our two leads were American. Jalen is 18 and Navia is 10. And most of the rest of our British cast were aged between 17 and early 20s. And we just had this fantastic melting pot, actually, of young actors comparing notes and having a great time. I think we are going to see more of a shift to on-demand and streaming. I think the BBC actually was ahead of the curve, and well done, BBC, with the iPlayer. Because I think, if I think about how I've watched TV in the last week, I've watched Netflix, Amazon, and the iPlayer, and ITV Hub. I actually caught up with Broadchurch on the ITV Hub. I have not turned television on this week. I don't think the British broadcasters need to be scared as long as they're kind of on the money. And when a lot of people were shouting and complaining about BBC Three moving to the iPlayer, I thought they were completely out of touch. And actually, of course, BBC Three should be on the iPlayer. And because I've got kids at home, one of whom is 13, I knew that she'd stopped watching traditional television several years ago. So she is the person who's going to watch it in that way. So yes, I think it's exciting. I don't think it means the end of how we make shows. I just think it means we need more, and there's more competition, and I hope it will keep going, because obviously that's good for us and everyone involved in the industry. Don't be annoying in auditions. You need to come in and you need to show you can act, and you also need to show you're someone we want to spend time with, because if we go on a journey, we may be spending every day for 3 months with you. So I think there is a danger that some actors come into an audition and think it's all about them. It's not all about you. It's about how do you portray that character, and how do you become the person we most want portraying that character. So someone who comes in and keeps going, oh, I've messed that up, oh, and it becomes about me, the person, rather than me, the actor, who can be professional. You can say, oh, I'm really sorry, I think I just made a mistake there, can I do it again? That's fine. But we don't need all the emoting that goes with it. I think also, don't rely on tricks. If you're auditioning and you're constantly flicking your hair or shaking your head, or there are tricks which become very boring to watch quite quickly and we spot them, you need to be still and natural and inhabit your character. It sounds obvious, but you would be amazed at how many people leave an audition room and we look at each other and go, I really hate talking about this business as business, and I really hate it when people start using business speak, but unfortunately even I have to remember sometimes it is a business, and that's sort of what we're all doing. It is ultimately, it's not a hobby.